Hello, I'm Christoph Hessing, and I'm in charge of technical product management at HUESKER Synthetic. In this videocast, I'm going to explain the reduction factor for the creep rupture behaviour of geosynthetics. The design of geosynthetic installations for soil reinforcement involves the use of the characteristic long-term strength value for the relevant material. This characteristic long-term strength is calculated by applying a series of reduction factors to the characteristic short-term strength of the geosynthetic product. The purpose of the reduction factors is to take into account the factors influencing product behavior that are likely to be significant in a particular application. Under the German EBGEO, the Recommendations for Design and Analysis of Earth Structures Using Geosynthetic Reinforcements, issued by the German Geotechnical Society, the reduction factor for creep rupture behavior is designated as A1. This is equivalent to the designation RFCR, reduction factor for creep rupture, used in the international guidelines for the determination of the long-term strength of geosynthetics for soil reinforcement, ISO/TR 20432. Geosynthetics comprise of polymer raw materials that exhibit elastoplastic behavior. Apart from elastic deformations, the products, when loaded, also undergo viscous time-dependent deformations, commonly referred to as creep. After a certain period of loading, these deformations lead to rupture. The time to creep rupture largely depends on the incorporated raw material, its processing, the load levels, and temperature. The creep rupture behavior of geosynthetics can be tested to DIN N ISO 13431. This involves subjecting the geosynthetic product to a series of different load levels and measuring the time it takes to rupture. The applied load levels correspond to a percentage of the product's short-term strength. The determined times to creep rupture are plotted against the applied load levels in a graph. A semi-logarithmic plot for a high tensile HUESKER polyester geogrid shows a linear trend that can be extrapolated over the projected design life by inserting a best fit line. The maximum allowable load level for the projected design life can then be determined as the intersection of the chosen time with the best fit line. As this example shows, the allowable load level for a 120-year design life is equal to 66% of the short-term strength. The A1 reduction factor, or RFCR, is then given as the reciprocal of the allowable load level. I hope that this presentation on the reduction factor for the creep rupture behavior of geosynthetics has captured your interest. Please let me draw your attention to our videocasts on other reduction factors that need to be applied in calculating the characteristic long-term strength of geosynthetics. Should you wish to know more about the technical details and HUESKER's solutions, then please take a look at our website or contact us directly.